Hello from the German capital, Berlin. Filmmakers, programmers and film journalists are flocking to Berlin these days. It is Berlinale time, Berlin's annual international film festival, which is taking place for the 68th time this year.
The Berlinale was founded in 1951, and the film festival was originally set up to bring some US-style glamour to West Berlin, the Western output in the middle of the communist East German state.
Since then, the Berlinale has become one of the most important film festivals in the world, perhaps even the most important one, and it is definitely the largest publicly attended film festival worldwide based on actual attendance with more than 500,000 admissions.
This year, there are around 400 films in 9 different film sections and several special presentations.
19 films are competing for the prestigious Golden and Silver Bears.
Part of the Berlinale is the Teddy Award for films with an LGBTIQ focus.
The Teddy Award is not a separate section of the Berlinale, but the films competing for the Teddy Award are from all film sections, including films from the official competition, as long as they have an LGBTIQ focus.
The Teddy Award films cover a wide spectrum, from feature films to documentaries and shorts. But because it is not a typical LGBTIQ festival, many of the entries test the limits of traditional LGBTIQ cinema and open up new approaches and directions. This makes the Teddy Awards special and different compared to many other LGBTIQ film festivals. The Teddy Award will be presented on Friday evening, and it is always dangerous to speculate on the possible winners. Details from the Margins Extra on the 5th of March will discuss more of the Teddy Award films, and I will also present the winners of the award.
Berlin is buzzing, and there are still a few more days to go for the Berlinale. This is Rainer Schulze for latest TV news.